Welcome back in this morning's Education Alert. Summer is a time for fun and for the kids, but how do we as parents make sure they keep reading and writing and don't forget what they learned during the school year? Well, Neil McNerney, author of A Homework, A Parent's Guide to Helping Out Without Freaking Out, is here with some tips. Thank you for coming in.
Well, thank you. I think the good part is try to make it a little bit different than school.
Yeah.
You know, try to hold off on the worksheets, try to hold off on the assigned readings, try to find some ways to make it fun.
Okay, so you have assignment, you have the reading list, and you have the math workbook that you've been given for, you know, the summer.
Mm-hmm.
So you throw it out the window?
Well, if it's required, don't throw it out the window. But find some other ways. You know, for instance, like Jenga. Most people have Jenga. But instead of just using the typical Jenga way, put some different things on the actual cubes. Mm-hmm. Like, what's your favorite president?
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, if it's a math thing, put some of the math facts on there. And when they have to pull it out, instead of just being able to pull it out, they've also got to answer the question. And it could be a creative question. It could be a math question. It could be a history question. It all works.
All right. And you say don't break the chain. What does that mean?
Don't break the chain basically is an idea of writing a story.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, get these just really simple little composition notebooks. Write a 2 or 3 sentence beginning of a story. Hand it to your kid and say, you write the next section. And then they'll hand it back to you,
mm-hmm.
and then you write the next section, make a story,
mm-hmm.
but you've got to include whatever's in the beginning that somebody else has already put there.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like two minds making up a story. It's
mm-hmm.
a lot of fun, mm-hmm. and it increases creativity, it increases writing, all the good stuff that we're looking for.
Okay. Mad Libs, you like that?
Mad Libs is great, and they're just basically little books that you can
mm-hmm.
buy, and you have to, there's little spaces where you have to put in a noun or a verb. And then once you read it back, it's hilarious how they come out. They come out really funny stories.
Funny. And what's Spy Family?
Spy Family is just a creative way that you can, when you're going on vacation, make up new names for each other. Completely new
that
names.
That could be dangerous.
It could be. You got to approve of the name. And make up a backstory. Maybe say you're from Australia and everybody has to have an Australian accent. Just try to make it a little bit more creative. That way you're developing creativity, you're developing story ideas. So it's just kind of a fun way to have more fun during the summer vacation.
All right, and so you say appoint a family trip accountant?
Yeah,
a great thing
for math is,
mm-hmm.
again, you can just use a composition notebook and being able to have one of the kids write down all the spending. And then they can add it together at the end of the day, figure out how much they're spending. They're learning, you know,
mm-hmm.
home economy, they're doing math, they're doing record keeping, lots of different ways to keep that going.
And this works up until age what? Because at some point they're going to say, I know what you're trying to do. I'd rather just text on my phone.
Yeah, exactly. They will. I'd say probably through middle school for a lot of kids, particularly the stories. You can continue
mm-hmm.
the stories, the chain stories. You can continue the family accountant and stuff into the teenage years.
Okay. And when teenage years, just lock them in their room.
Lock them in their room.
Yeah.
Turn off the internet.
Right.
Take their phone away, and you'll be fine.
There you go. Thank you, Neil, for coming in.
Thank you.
All right. Again, the name of the book is Homework, A Parent's Guide to Helping Out Without Freaking Out by Neil McNerney.